niggas barely got a brain. A damn shame, the girl can hardly spell her name.
That's not our problem, that's up to Brenda's family.
Well, let me show you how it affects our whole community. Now, Brenda really never knew her moms, and her dad was a junkie putting breath into his arms. It's sad, cause I bet Brenda doesn't even know. Just cause you're in the ghetto doesn't mean you can't grow. But that's a book, my own revelation. Do whatever it takes to resist the temptation. Brenda got herself a boyfriend. Her boyfriend was a cousin, now let's rock the joy. And she tried to hide a pregnancy from a family who really didn't care to see or give a damn if she went out and had a church of kids. As long as when the check came, they got first dibs. Now Brenda's belly's getting bigger, but no one seems to notice any change in her figure. She's 12 years older, she's having a baby, in love with a molester who's sexing her crazy. And yet, and also thinks that he'll be with her forever, and dreams of a world with the two of them are together. Whatever, he left there and she had the baby solo. She had it on the bathroom floor and didn't know, so she didn't know what to throw away and what to keep. She wrapped the baby up and threw him in a trash heap. I guess she thought she'd get away, wouldn't hear the cries. She didn't realize how much the little baby had her eyes. Now the baby's in a trash heap, bawling. Mama can't help her, but it hurts to hear her calling. Brenda wants to run away. Mama say you're making me lose pay, and social work is here every day. Now Brenda's gotta make her own way. Can't go to a family, they won't let her stay. No money, no babysitter, she couldn't keep a job. She tried to sell crack, but ended up getting robbed. So now what's next? It ain't nothing left to sell. So she sees sex as a way of leaving hell. It's paying the rent, so she really can't complain. Prostitute fans swing, and Brenda's a name, she's got a baby.